Greetings, Joseph Kursky here with you. Let's create a story map, a multimedia interactive web map. And let's use that story map to include a map, the field data, a dashboard, and other elements to communicate the results of our field investigation and get people excited about this investigation as they consume the content in our story map. Thanks. Let's say I wanted to create something like this. Why are storm drains so important to our water system? Why study storm drains? I've got some links in here. I've got some web pages, text, photos, interactive web maps, some of which we built together in prior tutorial videos in this same playlist series, along with our survey with a button there, map your storm drain, so they can participate in the survey, those that you want to share this story map with, and the results of those storm drains collected. How do we do this? Let's test out that survey. How do we get that survey into our story map? There's our survey right there where we originally collected the data with. So we started here with the survey. We went out in the field and collected data into it. The result was shown on a map. We then analyzed that result. Traced downstream, we created watersheds, we looked at hydro, real-time stream gauges, and other layers. In our subsequent work, we've created a dashboard. We've got a dashboard in this story map right now. So we've got a variety of elements that we've explored together here. Let's go ahead and find out how do we create one of these story maps. I've got other videos and there are other tutorials online about this, but let's just briefly continue with our theme of collect field data, map it, analyze it, create a dashboard, and create a story map. I've fired up the app launcher, as you just saw there, and once I do and I'm inside my organization, I can see an existing story map in there, but I'm going to go ahead and create a new one from scratch. Just like the dashboard and many other tools that you've seen in the ArcGIS platform, the story maps creation tools are very intuitive. They're all driven by this plus sign. What do you want to add? A map, a video, picture, text? So I'm going to go ahead and create that story map. And as you can see here, it's a matter of, okay, what do you want to create? Now there are more advanced things that you can do with story maps, but let's just focus on the basics here. Let's add a picture. Let's say I add that picture to my story map and I'm not so happy about it. It's a little grainy and it doesn't really show me the storm drain. It defaults to the sort of the mountains, in this case foothills of Colorado, behind the storm drain. So I'm going to go ahead and select a different photo just to illustrate that, you know, if you're not happy with something in your story map, go ahead and replace it with something else. And as you work through, there are elements that you can add easily, but also I'm giving short shrift of this particular element, but you got to think about before you sort of dive in and create a story map, who's your audience, what story do you want to tell, what kinds of elements should be in there, and so on. And there's some settings that we're going to, not just in this video anyway, give a whole lot of attention to, but realize that in this case I can say, oh, side by side, I kind of like that better, so I'm going to switch the panel placement, and now I've got my geeky photograph of me standing by a storm drain and the title next to it. So I'm liking that better than having the image take up the full panel at the top. I'm going to go ahead and add a map now. We've created a lot of maps together in this series. I've got all those maps sitting in my same ArcGIS Online organizational account, so I can choose them. If I want to pick maps outside of my own account, I can do that too. I can turn layers on and off inside that map and then decide to place it in here. No embed code needed. It already automatically embeds things. There's no HTMLing that you have to do here in this story maps creation zone. If you want to dig deeper though, there's certainly the web app builder and the experience builder so that you can actually have more power. Here I'm going to add a button. That button is going to point to my survey 123. I'm going to go and find that URL for the survey, because I want people to be able to go to the story map and click on that button and start collecting data. That would be a very nice one-stop shop, wouldn't it? Here's my URL there. So now I've got the survey inside my story map, and let's go ahead and add something else. What else might we want to add? How about a blank or a horizontal line there? How about a video? I've got a video of me standing by that storm drain explaining why and how I think this is so critical to teaching and learning, critical thinking, spatial thinking, etc., using ordinary objects on the landscape like trees, light poles, storm drains, etc. So I've got that as well as a dashboard. As you remember from the dashboard video, I've got that video link here. I can go ahead and add it to my story map. And here's another teachable moment. Why would you want to use story maps over dashboard or experience builder or any of the other tools that are inside that ArcGIS platform? Well, just like other things in education, you can't use them all. You shouldn't use them all, and you shouldn't use them just because they exist. Use the ones that are appropriate for your needs. Don't just put things in because they exist. I'm going to add my dashboard in here because I want my story map to point to the common elements that I've created to analyze the situation with storm drains, why they matter, why they're important, the function that they serve in the community, and so on. So now I've got, with just a few clicks here, with about, 5 minutes that we've spent on this story map, I have my image at the top, I've got some text. Maybe I want to add a little bit more text. Let's go ahead and paste that in from, in this case, another story map, but you could paste it in from a web page or from something you've written, a Word doc, etc. You might have to do a little bit of font adjustment, but you have, wow, that's pretty powerful. I can paste it right in and it preserves the fonts and colors from my other content there. So now I'm going to go ahead and go down to the bottom of it and put some credits in here. It's always important to put metadata. There's a metadata page for every story map, but sometimes it's, usually it's very helpful to the reader to have it inside the story map as well. And so this was in conjunction with the Data Citizens Western New York project, a very wonderful combining universities, K-12 teachers, students, and community kind of a project and community organizations. So I wanted to acknowledge those good folks. There's also a credits zone inside the story map where you can add additional things. So I'm going to do that here just to show you what that looks like. We are making progress on our story map. In about 10 minutes, we have all of the elements that we need for a basic but compelling, powerful story map. Very good. I'm liking that a lot. Let's go ahead and preview this. Let's see what it looks like on a tablet, on a phone, on a desktop computer or a laptop. It's looking pretty good. I'm really satisfied with this, folks. Now remember, there are lots of layers in those web maps that we created together, so you have to have a little patience in when you're previewing this to make sure they all draw. Data as services is powerful, but again, that's a lot of that points, lines, and polygons and imagery that you're slinging around, much of which is in near real-time or real-time, like the satellite imagery or the stream gauges. This is what it looks like on a phone. I'm happy with that as well. That's what's nice about these story maps. They automatically configure themselves to different device sizes, which is really powerful. My survey is working. That's great. This is what it looks like on a tablet. Again, I'm very happy with this. There are my credits at the bottom, my dashboard, my link to my survey, my images, my text. Very good. Okay. Let's go ahead and publish this. This is where you can determine who's going to see your story map. In my case, I want to share it with my organization that I'm working with, this group of educators. And so I'm going to publish that story. There it is. Got my photo, my title at the top. I'm liking that a lot. Inside my organization, just to review, you and I have content. And the latest and greatest should be sitting right at the top. In my case, it's that story map I just made. But notice I've got feature layers, which are sort of like the layers, the Lego bricks inside the map. Web maps, I've got my original survey in here as well. Got some images that I've uploaded. There's my survey that I can collect data into on storm drains. That's part of my story map now. And I've got this web map in there along with my weather and stream gauges and my watersheds and my hydro layer. Wow, got a lot in here, but the point is that water is complex and it's a natural thing, but it's influenced by the natural environment and also by human-built treatment plants and diversions and all sorts of other things. Water use, there's lots you can teach with water, as I explain in another video. Here's my story map once again. Test it and make sure everything works. There's my video embedded in there. And I've got my dashboard in there with my two maps. Come back to that in a bit. Make sure it draws. Excellent. Again, more is not always better, so you want to be careful about the number of layers that you have inside your maps. There's my static images, my links. Very good. Story map's looking good. Now with a story map, I can share that with people and they can go in and explore what are storm drains, why do they matter? And they can even collect data into it because I've got the crowdsourced survey sitting inside my story map. Actually, at the moment, I only have that shared with my organization. But the point is, you could share it with the general public. I want to change that back. This is just to illustrate. If you've got a story map that you want to make some adjustments to, it's pretty easy to do. And remember this side-by-side configuration. All right, looking good there. Scroll through my story map one more time, verifying all the elements are there. And if not, I can go ahead and make adjustments, but I'm happy with that. And within a short time, we have created a survey, a web layer, a web map, a 3D map, a 3D scene. Remember that one tutorial that we looked at? We have also created a dashboard. We have also created a story map. Here's my final story map. So within a couple of short tutorials, you and I have the capability of doing some very powerful things that can engage students and others in really understanding their world on down to the community level. Thanks.